My brothers and sisters, we have an excellent gospel today, and these readings go perfectly with the feast day, the Nativity of the Virgin Mary. Let's begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Great crowds were traveling with Jesus, and he turned and addressed them, "If anyone comes to me without hating his father and mother, wife and children, brothers and sisters, and even his own life, he cannot be my disciple. Whoever does not carry his own cross and come after me cannot be my disciple. Which of you, wishing to construct a tower, does not first sit down and calculate the cost to see if there is enough for its completion? Otherwise, after laying the foundation and finding himself unable to finish the work, the onlookers should laugh at him and say, 'This one began to build, but did not have the resources to finish.' Or what king marching into battle would not first sit down and decide whether with 10,000 troops he can successfully oppose another king, advancing upon him with 20,000 troops? But if not, while he is still far away, he will send a delegation to ask for peace terms. In the same way, any one of you who does not renounce all his possessions cannot be my disciple." Amen. I really like this gospel because this really helps us to see the true Jesus Christ. We're often presented by the world with a false Jesus, this soft, cuddly Jesus who will let us get away with anything, who doesn't have these great demands on us. Now here, Jesus is not meaning for us to literally hate our wives and our children and our very selves. He does not mean that. He wants our love. The cost of discipleship is the love of Jesus Christ above all other loves. We as humans get into trouble very often because, yes, we put Jesus second and other people first, but the sin that I'm speaking of here is human respect. Sometimes we care too much about what other people think and not enough about what God thinks. And Jesus here is telling us, first, God, above all else, all of these other attachments, all of these other loves that we have, these come only after Christ. But he does not mean literally go out and hate them. Our Lord says, love your neighbor as yourself, love your enemies. So Jesus here is not saying hate, he's saying love him above all else, even at the cost of your relationships. Although our relationships will only be enhanced, truly enhanced, when we love out of love for Christ. Now Jesus does something very beautiful that I think is very awesome. He makes very practical advice here. Stephen Covey, the author of 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, his second habit for highly effective people is to start with the end in mind. And that is what Jesus is saying here. Very practical. Start with the end in mind. A lot of times we are not successful and we just kind of roam throughout life because we have not thought of our goals. We think of our goals, we look at our life and we say, is what I am doing right now going to help me to achieve that goal? This applies in business. This applies in family life. But most importantly, this applies in the spiritual life. So just as you would put a goal forth and say, what do I need to do day by day to reach this goal? What do I need to do to make sure that I am not veering from my intended path? Similarly, in the spiritual life, we have to put the end in mind. What is the end in mind? It's our salvation. It's our sanctification. It's heaven. It's being ready at the hour of our death. We need to look at our lives. What is it going to take for me to be ready when that time comes? So I encourage you to write down your goals, to look at your life, to re-examine all the things that you do. Are you constantly in mortal sin now? Then what makes you think that at the hour of your death, you're going to be ready? If your family members, objectively speaking, if you're looking at them now and they're not going to make it now, what makes you think at the hour of their death they're going to be ready? So how do I know if I will be ready at the hour of my death? I'm going to give you a secret. Can you guess what it would be? How will I know if I'm going to be ready at the hour of my death? Answer the question. Am I ready now? Be ready now. Die to yourself right now. St. Paul says that I no longer live, but it is Christ living in me. So we have to put all of our disordered attachments to sin to death now. And in a way, I'm saying, Lord, I surrender to you my wife. I surrender to you my children. I surrender my job. Everything that I'm going to have to let go of at the hour of my death, I need to be ready to let go of it right now. And this death to self doesn't just happen automatically. It's not just an act of the will. Yes, I need to engage the will. I need to fight manfully. I need to wake up in the morning when my alarm goes off. I need to fight against my temptations and my tendencies to cling to things and to cling to sin. That is not what is going to happen all of a sudden out of nowhere because of my willpower alone. I cannot save myself. I need the grace and the help of Jesus Christ, and that's going to come through prayer, which brings us to the feast day that's going to be celebrated this Sunday or today, depending on when you're watching this, and that is the Nativity of the Virgin Mary. Saint Alphonsus de Liguori says that Our Lady was perfectly united to the will of God throughout her entire life. That means Mary's will was perfectly united to God's will. Mary's self-will and self-love, she crushed it through the grace and mercy of God, and she obeyed God in all things. Saint Maximilian Kolbe said that Mary is the quasi-incarnation of the Holy Spirit. Quasi-incarnation. What does that mean? That means if the Holy Spirit had flesh, if the Holy Spirit had a human face, that face would look like the face of the Virgin Mary. Why is this important? Because Mary is teaching us something very valuable. Sanctity, holiness, is uniting my will to the will of God and doing those things out of great love. I said earlier that we cannot just do this manfully by my own willpower. Yes, I need to come at the spiritual life and all the self-mastery with all my force of the will as possible, but I need help. And the greatest help comes from the Virgin Mary. We need Mary's help above all else. St. Thomas of Villanova says that the greatest sign of your salvation, the greatest sign that you are going to be in heaven, is devotion to the Virgin Mary. And now, nobody ever clarifies how much devotion is necessary. And I would argue that if you're trying to save the souls of your family members, start with even the smallest devotion to the Virgin Mary. Implant in them, get them to promise that I will pray even one single Hail Mary every single morning. Many of you have family and friends, you've got children who don't go to church, they don't love God. Tell them, please, I'm begging you, for the sake of your soul, pray at least one Hail Mary every single morning. And you might say to me, Gabriel, one Hail Mary, that's nothing, that's so little. But you have to remember, the Virgin Mary entered this world as a baby. She entered this world very small, and she grew, and in the fullness of time, she brought forth Jesus Christ into the world. And so the same way, she will replicate this, and God will replicate this in the souls of those who are faithful to her. Now, I mentioned earlier that you want to be dead to yourself. You want to let God live through you. And this perfect answer that I'm trying to propose to you now is through Marian consecration. So many people go through Marian consecration initially as some sort of bargaining where I'm going to give Mary my merits and she's going to get me a good return on my investment. And that's okay. It doesn't have to, when you start your Marian consecration, it does not have to be perfect. But the end of Marian consecration is the end that you want to have at the end of your entire life, is that you no longer live, that you and God are perfectly united. And that's what it is to enter heaven. You can't have any disordered attachment to sin. And that's what we want to uproot. We want to love the Lord our God above all else. That's what Jesus is asking of his followers in this gospel, to love Jesus more than any disordered attachment that we have to our family, to our possessions, to our friends, and to any social media, to our image. And so what am I saying with Marian consecration? Marian consecration isn't just giving Mary your merits. Yes, give her your merits. Give her your goals. Give her your dreams. Give her your will. Give her your words. Give her your very life. Give her everything. When you wake up in the morning, you should say, I am no longer alive. Let me fight against my will. Mary, what do you want of me this day? The hardest death to self, the hardest thing that most of us will have a difficulty breaking an attachment to is our own self-will and our own self-love. And it starts in the morning. When we wake up in the morning, we're very tired. We just want to lay in the bed a little longer. We want comfort. So the very first thing you do when your soul has awareness, when you're able to reflect, think, I give you everything, Mary. And throughout the day, say, Mary, what do you want of me? What is your will for me? What should I be doing right now? Something that I have found very helpful in the mornings is I get a daily email from St. Maximilian Kolbe or the Militia of the Immaculata with a quote on Marian consecration. I will share that in the description section of this video. Our goal is that we die and that we allow Mary and Jesus to live through us so that when we go to work, our co-workers can see the face of Mary through our face. Now, we keep our personality, but everything we're doing, we're saying, Mary, what would you have me do? We're her slave. We're her instrument. And through this, then you'll see miracles. Many of the saints have said, and I've mentioned this several times, is that Mary has a will for us, especially us consecrated souls. Mary has a will for us, and we do not allow her to work the miracles of grace that she desires to work, that God's providence wishes to work through these little acts that we do, because we are not open to doing her will. And this is a constant killing of our will. And we do this, we have to have Marian holy reminders, out of sight, out of mind. I wear my miraculous medal frequently. Again, I'm always encouraging you to wear your brown scapular. I'm always carrying my rosary with me at all times because we need these constant physical reminders to remind us to whom we belong. It is no longer us that lives. It is Jesus Christ living in us. It is the Virgin Mary living in us. That brings us to two things. There's two ways to think of your Marian consecration. Saint Maximilian Kolbe would speak of it as Mary possessing me. She's possessing me. I want her spirit to possess me. I want people to see the Virgin Mary. And I use this language interchangeably. There's another way to think of it, because maybe you're not quite used to this, is you are now another Christ. You are a child Christ. And you are doing Mary's will in all things. You say, Gabriel, why are you constantly doing Mary's will? What about God's will? They're the same will. And when Jesus Christ was a child, he submitted his will to the will of the Virgin Mary. And guess what? They had the same will. So too, you could think of this as you are another Christ. Christ is speaking through you. Christ is manifesting himself through you. But you are just a child. And so you are doing the will of your Holy Mother. So again, we must strive to die. Jesus is saying we have to start with the end in mind. The end in mind is union with God, and that starts right here, that starts right now. Love the Virgin Mary, and she will bring Jesus into your soul in a way that by your own willpower or by going straight to Jesus alone will not work. I am constantly going to be bringing up the Virgin Mary because she is the greatest, she is the quickest, she is the best means, and we need to do everything that we can as souls consecrated to her to bring Jesus to people, but through the Virgin Mary. We can change the world through Marian devotion, but we have to be very deliberate in it and make sure we call to mind her will and call to mind her intercession. Let's close in prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Blessed Virgin Mary, we need your help. We are weak. We have inclinations to sin. We are attached to so many things. We're attached to our own will. It is through your prayer that we wish to become another Jesus Christ. We wish to allow you to work in the lives of our family and our friends and everybody that we meet. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. God bless you all, my friends. I appreciate your support. I think of you often, I pray for you frequently, and I encourage you, if you feel called, if you feel moved by this little gospel reflection, to share it with your family and friends. Although I have this uploaded as unlisted, it is still shareable through YouTube. Also, I do make this public for a short period of time, simply so that we can reach as many souls as possible. God bless you, God love you, I'm praying for you, have a great day.